They're more partisan, more tribal.
John McCain wanted to give this speech about Senate dysfunction before his brain cancer diagnosis last summer. Then, longtime aide, speechwriter, and friend Mark Salter got a call from McCain with a sudden urgency.
You know, you're coming out here, what's the story? And I said, yeah, well, here's what I want to say in the speech. And I said, well, have you gotten the results back? You know, what is it? He goes, it's not good.
Salter rushed to Arizona. They finished the speech on the flight back to D.C.
What have we to lose by trying to work together?
They all stayed in their chairs for his speech. That had never happened in his career, and it meant a great deal to him.
McCain and Salter were already working on their seventh book together, which instantly took a reflective turn.
He wanted to be more personal and to convey just how fortunate he believed he was for being able to serve his country for 60 years.
The result? The Restless Wave.
I want to talk to my fellow Americans a little more, if I may. My fellow Americans, no association ever mattered more to me.
This book allows McCain to tie up some loose ends, publicly admitting for the first time that during his 2008 presidential run, Joe Lieberman was his first choice for his running mate.
We all knew it, covering him, but him saying it is a whole different thing.
His aides, and among them myself, had persuaded him that it wouldn't be possible.
They told McCain putting a Democrat turned independent on a Republican presidential ticket would spark a convention revolt.
He wanted to pick Joe Lieberman, but he has never expressed any regret, not privately, nor certainly publicly, about picking Governor Palin.
McCain also explains being approached in 2016 with the now famous dossier about Donald Trump.
He went over to see the FBI director at his earliest convenience and delivered it to him and said, I assume you will vet this.
I discharged that obligation and I would do it again. Anyone who doesn't like it can go to hell.
I wrote that, but he said it just that way.
For over 30 years, Salter has helped McCain convey his essence.
You've written a lot of words for and with John McCain. What do you think the most important are?
We were born to love and we were born to have the courage for it. So be brave, the rest is easy. I thought that was the most McCain-esque thing he ever said.
That, or maybe this, in the final chapter.
We need each other. We need friends in the world and they need us. The bell tolls for us, my friends.
That, of course, is a reference to For Whom the Bell Tolls by Ernest Hemingway, McCain's favorite book. The fictional protagonist, Robert Jordan, is a larger-than-life romantic war hero, a North Star for McCain his whole life. And, Jake, in the last full page of this book, after talking about how lucky he has been to live with great passions, to fight a war, to make peace, he says the following, quote, from Hemingway's Robert Jordan. He says, the world is a fine place and worth fighting for, and I hate very much to leave it.